الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد وبارك وسلم وصلوا عليه تمام معزز محترم مہمان اور اساتذہ کو اور طلبہ طالبات کو السلام علیکم
شالو جی بنیادی طور پر شالو جی کی ایک برانچ ہے اور یہ آج یقیناً ایک بہت اچھا ڈپارٹمنٹ ہے ایک اچھی فیلڈ ہے اس میں ہم لوگ جو کرمنالوجی کے حوالے سے پروسیجر آف ایویڈنس ہیں آپ کے پاس اس میں جسٹس سسٹم ہے اس کے علاوہ یقیناً دوسرے جو سبجیکٹس ہیں جو کرمنالوجی سے ریلیٹڈ ہیں جس میں مینٹل ہیلتھ ہے ڈرگ ابیوز ہے کریکشن انسٹیٹیوشنس ہیں وہ ہم بچوں کے ساتھ انٹریکشن کرتے ہیں اور ان کو اس حوالے سے یقیناً آج جو آپ کو بلانے کا مقصد بھی یہ کہ آپ ان موضوعات پہ ان بچوں کے ساتھ انٹریکشن کریں گے اور اس پہ روشنی ڈالیں گے
اور ہمارے بچوں کے لیے آج ہمارے پاس ایک پریکٹیکل جوڈیشل اور لا آفیسر ہیں جو کہ قانون کے گرفت رکھتے ہیں اور سارے پروز اینڈ کونس قانون کے جانتے ہیں اور لا کو بہتر جانتے ہیں ہم سب سے بہتر جانتے ہیں اور اس وقت وہ پریکٹسنگ انڈیویجول ہیں کیا کہتے ہیں پرسنل ہیں اور ان چیزوں کو بہتر سمجھتے ہیں تو آئی ایم اگین ویلکم اینڈ انوائٹ سر موسٹ آنریبل یور ہائینس ڈاکٹر اقبال ظفر صاحب
الرحیم لیڈیز اینڈ جینٹلمین دس ٹاک از گوئنگ ٹو بی اے ٹو وے ٹاک یو کین آسک می اینی کوشچن ود ان دی ڈسکشن اینڈ آئی کین آسک یو اینی کوشچن ایٹ اینی ٹائم فرسٹ آف آل آئی وڈ لائک ٹو نو دیٹ وٹ ڈو یو انڈرسٹینڈ بائی دی ورڈ کرائم ایون اف یو آر اسٹڈیئنگ اٹ فرام اے سوشیولوجیکل پرسپیکٹیو ایون دین وٹ ڈو یو تھنک why a crime takes place, where is the break, and when the element of crime enters into our minds. Anybody? Yes.
Sir, crime is some act that is against criminal law. It takes place because for example, the government does not give some employment to someone. So when he does not get any earning, so then he becomes a criminal.
Anybody else? Yes.
Violation of law is said to be crime.
An illegal act against the rules or regulation of a state is called a crime.
Any?
Illegal act against the rules and regulation of a state.
Anybody else?
Any act that is against the law has
a
certain amount of punishment against it. What is law?
Okay. What is law?
Laws are set of codes designed by the government to practice by the citizens.
Boundaries within which an individual is forced to, is bound to live his life or perform his duties.
Anybody else?
Rules and regulation of a particular state.
Have you heard of any white-collar crime taking place somewhere in known white-collar crime?
Corruption.
Oh. Yes, corruption is a white-collar crime.
Okay.
Bank fraud. Money laundering. Yes.
Tax evasion.
Tax evasion. Panama paper is also a money laundering, nothing else. Because when you hide the money and its source is not legal. You see, in money laundering, the important thing is the source of money. It is the source. If it is a source which is wrong, it is a source which has been gathered from corruption or some illegal ways or some illegal, then it becomes money laundering. But if the source is correct, then it's not money. This is very important.
Sir, the source is correct and they are taking a large amount of money. So without the involvement of the bank, that is also not
money. See, what is the specific? You see, there are laws under the Economic Reforms Act of 1992 in Pakistan. If you are maintaining an account with the bank and you are depositing foreign exchange, you are entitled to send it anywhere in the world.
They are taking it with us in a plane
there is a limit, $10,000. If you are going beyond $10,000, only then it becomes an offense. If you are going beyond $10,000, then it becomes an offense. It is an offense, even under the Foreign Exchange Regulation Act. See, there can be one act, there can be many offenses. It is an offense under the Foreign Exchange Regulation Act, one thing, because you have not declared and you are going out money which is beyond 10,000 limits. Second thing, where from you got the money? If the money is tainted, then it is a crime of money laundering. If money is tainted, if the money is not tainted, then it's not a crime of money laundering. Third thing, corruption. It's an offense of corruption. Fourth, so many things. I mean, it depends. You have to find it out from the facts presented to you that what is the actual crime. That is the investigation part of any crime. Any other idea? As far as law is concerned, law basically recognizes body of rules which are recognized and applied by the state in its administration of justice. Law is dependent on those body of rules which are recognized by the state in its administration of justice. So where there is a violation of these rules, obviously it leads to a crime. So when we talk of white collar crimes, they are crimes which are related to a specific part of the society. The people who are otherwise known as very honorable, the people who are otherwise acceptable in the society, have a particular position in the society. Now they are dealing with different kinds of, yes? They are dealing with different institutions. They are dealing with different departments of the government. They are dealing with different individuals. When they act and manipulate their acts in a way that it causes harm either to an individual or to a body or to an institution or to the government. When it causes a harm, it is an offense. Example, making a false statement to obtain a loan. When you obtain a loan from a bank and you are making a false statement, and as a consequence of that, you run away, money is not returned to the bank. It is a crime which is known as a white collar crime. Then, there are many other crimes, but today I will be talking very specifically about a crime which is known as insider trading. Have you heard this name?
Yes.
Heard? Insider trading. What is insider trading?
Basically, stocks leak the news from inside about the profit and loss. So this is
it's not leaked, first of all. The news is not leaked. They have a classified information with them and they obtain benefit out of it.
Exactly.
And this information is not known to the public.
Exactly. So that's how they, you know, tell the people about it for the sake of their financial game and all. This is what we study about.
So, in insider trading, there is an individual who is in control of a specified information, and then a particular event is going to take place. And this information is not known to the general public. And as a consequence of that information, the value of the share of the company can go up or it can go down. So, if he obtains benefit by purchasing the shares of that company, so he is committing a crime of insider trading, which is an offense. Insider trading can be both. It can be positive and negative. If you reveal that information to the general public, then it is not a crime. But if you do not reveal that information to the public, then it is a crime. So, how it happens and to what extent it will go, we will undertake a study. So, there should be how many? 10 groups. You divide yourself into 10 groups. अपने प्रॉमिस करती है लोगों से तो वो प्रॉमिस से तोड़ा तो ये यहाँ से आप पिकअप कीजिए चीजों जी दूसरा ग्रुप नहीं नहीं आप अपने व्यूज बताइए आप क्या समझ पाए हैं इससे और इसमें क्या बुनियादी बातें थी और
जैसा उन्होंने कंटिन्यू किया कि इनसाइड ट्रेडिंग का टाइम था तो इसमें आई थिंक जो इन्फॉर्मेशन बाकी कंपनीज के लिए अवेलेबल थी और जो राज की जो कंपनी थी उसके उसके पास एक्स्ट्रा इन्फॉर्मेशन थी यानी फेयर मीन्स नहीं थे लाइक जितनी इन्फॉर्मेशन या तो सबके पास उतनी होती तो उस तरह से वो बिजनेस करते उस तरह से वो ट्रेडिंग करते तो फेयर होता लेकिन उसके पास उसने एक क्राइम नहीं किया कि ही रिसीव्ड द अदर पीपल और उसने इन्फॉर्मेशन जो है वो इलीगल मीन्स
उसने व्हाट ही डिड वाज दैट two things he placed certain persons in the board of directors and he hired certain person for providing him the information
yeah, he cheated
ji any other group yes
sir ye jo raj
raj raj raja ratnam
raja ratnam sir ye investor tha
isne ye investor nahi tha he was managing
इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ द कंपनी तो सर उसने रैपिडली जो एक इन्वेस्टमेंट करता रहा और 1 बिलियन का टर्नओवर जो कंपनी का था वो कुछ सालों बाद उस बंदे के अकेले की वर्थ 1 बिलियन डॉलर हो गई और सर उसमें उसको जो डिफेंस लॉयर था उसने ये क्लेम किया कि इन्होंने जो है वो डिफरेंट न्यूज़ेस और आर्टिकल्स पढ़ के एनालाइज करके ये
उन्होंने क्लेम किया कि ये इंफॉर्मेशन जो थी पब्लिकली अवेलेबल थी
उन्होंने उसमें से जो है एनालाइज करके ये जो डील्स करी है वो सब क्या है मगर जो एफबीआई उनपे केस कर एफबीआई ने तफ्तीश के दौरान उनके फोन टैप और जो वायर्ड कम्युनिकेशन थी उसमें पिछला रिकॉर्ड फराम किया जिसमें उनके मल्टीपल कंपनीज से कारोबार थे जिसमें गूगल भी शामिल थे और जानी मानी कंपनियां तो उनके डिफेंस लॉयर ने क्लेम किया मगर उसमें जब उन्होंने ये दिखा दिए कि उनके डिफरेंट कंपनीज के वर्कर्स और ये बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर के बंदों के साथ ताल्लुकात थे जो उसे इन्फॉर्मेशन दे रहे थे कि नेक्स्ट वीक जो है फला कंपनी के शेयर $2 तक गिर जाएंगे फ्री शेयर तो उसने वो इन्फॉर्मेशन अगर वो जनरल पब्लिक के साथ शेयर कर देता तो वो क्राइम नहीं रहता मगर उसने वो सिर्फ अपने साथ और अपने खास खास लोगों को वो इन्फॉर्मेशन दी इसलिए उस पर फिर ये गिल्टी उसे करार दिया
गया जो है उसकी अभी एक किताब आई है डूइंग जस्टिस और उसमें उसने आपका जो एरिया है जो आपकी फील्ड है जो जिस चीज में आप मास्टर्स कर रहे हैं उस तमाम चीजों को उसने एक्सप्लेन किया है कि इंफॉर्मेशन क्या होती है रिपोर्ट कैसे की जाती है प्रोसिक्यूशन कैसे होती है डिफेंस क्या होता है जज क्या काम करता है पनिशमेंट कैसे होती है सो इफ यू रियली वांट टू गेन एन इनसाइट जो आपकी अपनी फील्ड है तो डू रीड दिस बुक आई हैव ऑल्सो एक मैं आपको फेरिस भी दे रहा हूँ इसमें इसी चीज से अगर आपने अंडरस्टैंड करना है कि ये क्राइम की दुनिया है क्या और क्राइम किस लेवल पर है आपकी जिस बुक से आप पढ़ रहे हो उससे आपको अंदाजा नहीं हो सकता तो ये एक पूरी लिस्ट है 10 किताबों की आई एम गोइंग टू योर प्रोफेसर लेकिन अगर आप उसको अच्छी तरह समझना चाहते हैं तो डू रीड जस्टिस बाय प्रीभा बराबर सो एनीथिंग एल्स particularly you have to be section 23, section 24, section 25, section 28, section 38, sorry, section 33 and section 37, section 38, 52 and 52A. These are the definition of different kinds of crimes. And then, as far as criminal breach of trust is concerned, you have to see section 405, 406, 407, 405, 406, 407, 408, 409, 410, 411, 412, 413, 414, 415, 416, 417, 418, 419, and 420. And then, how the Pakistani Authorities Act, you have to take into account the schedule to the FIE Act of 1974. All the offenses which have been added into this schedule, they are offenses relating to different kinds of crimes, including white-collar crimes. And I am providing all this to your professor, and you can take from him. All this.
Thank you, sir.
Then, as far as banks are concerned and bank frauds are concerned, I am providing you with the top 100 bank fraud cases which has happened in the Indian jurisdiction, and you can go through them also, so you have a fair idea that what kind of bank fraud takes place. And then whatever I have covered, this is a small talk by me, and a copy of it is also being given so that you can use it. Any questions now?
Sir, how do you see the role of judiciary in prevention of white-collar crime in Pakistan?
The role of judiciary is only to the extent of punishing people and finding out whether or not the people who are bringing the complaint, they are true or not. So, it basically depends. It's not the judiciary or A, B, or C. It's basically the society itself. Judiciary, I mean, you can have different views. That case goes to a judge. There are two options. Either the man is going to be free or he is going to be behind bars. It depends on the kind of investigation conducted, on the kinds of evidence collected, because the judge is bound by the rules of evidence. Judge is not an independent person. On record, what are the rules of evidence? They determine your guilt. If according to the rules of evidence, you are guilty, you are guilty. And if you are not guilty, you are not guilty. But the problem is that you have to understand the basic thing. The basic thing is that the two-way relationship between two individuals, commitments, promises, dealings. Unless and until we are not going to be more courageous, we should tell the night as a night and the day as a day. If we are not courageous, then certainly they will need to cry. 9 out of 10 cases, fundamentally, whether he is a criminal, hardcore criminal, or a new criminal, the basic reason is courage. They lack courage. They do not want to face the world. If you want to face the world, you have to be a true person. A person who says, the day is day and night is night. You should have the courage. One thing. Second thing, you are studying criminology. Now, criminology gives you a brief idea about the world of crime. But if you really want to be a practitioner, then you will have to go into the field of law and pick up the various areas of crime world. Say, for example, white-collar crime. White-collar crime is now being offered as an individual subject for a master's degree in law, LLM, by many outstanding universities like Columbia, like New York University, like Harvard University, University of Southern California, so many universities. And the annual income, if you graduate from that university, get a degree, is $160,000 per annum. That's worth it. So if you are really interested to pursue your further fields, then my advice will be enter into the field of law, because that is the field where you can earn money. Not going to a bank, not going to any institutions, because there you will have very, very limited resources on you.
On behalf of my students and department and university, I would pay my respectful thanks to Dr. Zafar Iqbal Sahib, who is very much honored to us and have a time and spend a very reasonable and interactive with case study methods. That was a great learning, and I hope that you have also learned a good lesson. So that is a great achievement for us. और इससे बड़ी अच्छी बात कि उन्होंने इतना स्टफ दे दिया हमें कि फर्दर आपको जो प्रैक्टिकल नॉलेज है वो इन केस स्टडीज के हवाले से जो आपने पढ़ा है, तो दैट वुड बी ग्रेट लर्निंग फॉर यू और इट्स अ गुड इंसाइट में. सो आई एम वेरी मच थैंकफुल टू डॉक्टर साहब फॉर कमिंग ओवर हियर एंड आई वुड अगेन रिक्वेस्ट हिम टू कम ओवर हियर एंड यू नो हैव अ. Okay.